it all comes down to today. For the first time since 2016, the Florida Eels are competing in the USPHL National Championship as they are one win away from claiming the gold, but first they have to get through the Charlotte Rush. Hello, everybody, and welcome into the Florida Eels Broadcast Network. Nick Rush giving you the play-by-play from Chilled Ponds Ice Sports Complex in Chesapeake, Virginia. The Florida Eels had a long, winding road to get to this point. It all started in the round robin Wednesday through Friday, where they went 2-0-1 before beating the Carolina Junior Canes in the national semifinal round 4-1 last night. For the Charlotte Rush, they also went 2-0-1 in the round robin, and they punched their ticket to the national championship last night with a massive 10-1 win over the Northern Cyclones. It's sure to be a legendary game, which these boys will remember for the rest of their lives, and it is coming up in moments. We'll step aside for the national anthem and return for your starting lineups, the goaltender matchup, and the play-by-play of the action right here on the Florida Eels Broadcast Network National Championship game coming up in the USPHL Premier Division. The national anthem has concluded here at the Chilled Ponds Ice Sports Complex, and that means we are ready for hockey on a Monday afternoon. It's your USPHL Premier Level National Championship game between the Florida Eels and the Charlotte Rush. Florida Eels for the starting lineup. They'll bring out the defensemen Crossley, Stewart, and Gage McNeish for the opening puck drop. Three forwards kicking off the game for Florida. Demid Podrazov, Gage Dill, and Casey Gerstein. Alex Caron, the man in between the pipes off to my right. Now for the Charlotte Rush starting lineup. Austin Klein and Jackson Olsen starting the game defensively. Anthony Vidrick, Charlie Merkley, and Ethan DeMumbrum at forward. Players taking their positions out across the center ice. Florida Eels moving from right to left across your computer screen. Left to right move to Charlotte Rush as they're donning their home white jerseys with the red bands around the arms, red numbering on the back, red pants, white socks with the red stripe, and red helmets. Florida Eels working in their road black jerseys with the green bands around the arms, white numbering on the back, black pants, green socks, and black helmets. The puck has dropped, and we are underway. Charlotte Rush win the faceoff as they dip back in their own zone. Jackson Olsen flings it down the rest of the ice, nearly caught out of midair by Alex Caron, and it's washed out to center ice for Demid Podrazov. Podrazov carries it out in front of the penalty box wall, now turned over by DeMumbrum at the center logo. Gage Dill getting his tape in the way, and he finesses it to his man Demid Podrazov in the nearest circle. Left wing out across center ice, Jackson Olsen tatters it forward across the blue line. And from there, Crossley Stewart takes over, zips it out through mid-rink, and it's down the length of the ice to Battisti. Battisti paddles a puck behind his own net, tended to from there by Jackson Olsen. Olsen trying to go zone to zone, and that gets forked wide by Tristan Roost as he re-enters the Florida Eels attacking zone. Swigert unable to keep it in, held onto by Edward Malakian as he waits along the narrow goal line. He's whipped down from behind, no call made by the head referee. Snapped out to neutral, Davis now for the Rush. Davis intercepted by Malakian at the near side half wall. Pass goes awry, intended to Demid Podrazov. And the puck floats down the length of the ice for an icing, your first whistle of the afternoon. 1:11 into the game, 0-0 between the Eels and Rush as a part of your national championship in the USPHL Premier. We thank you for tuning in and for making us a part of your Monday afternoon. Nick Rush giving you the play-by-play from Hampton Roads, Virginia. Faceoff coming blocker side for Alex Caron. Redirected out to center by Tristan Roost. Booth at his own blue line. Sam Martin with the give and go. Malakian making things difficult. Breakaway for the Eels. Court, left side, deep shot goes wide. Oh my goodness, he had half the net wide open, but he couldn't pot it home. Tristan Roos now involved in a four-man jam at the hash. Slap shot by Stewart. Blockered away by Battisti. He's covering up, but the whistle doesn't blow, and he keeps the puck alive eventually. And he held the puck in the glove for a good 2 seconds at least. Ricocheted out to the low slot. Out to center in between the benches. It's Colin Patterson. Patterson careens it behind the cage. Tried to backhand it out in front, but nobody home in the Florida Eels black and green uniform. And complete pass for the rush, one end to the other. And the whistle is blown for an icing. It's time to bring you the goaltender matchup for the Eels. Off to my right again, it's Alex Garone. Throughout the 2020-21 campaign, he played 24 games, combining for a .272 goals against average and a .916 save percentage. For the rush, to my left, it's David Battisti in the crease. 5 feet 11 inches tall, 34 games throughout the season. That's good for a .184 goals against average and a .938 save percentage. Scattered back out at the middle of the ice for Trevor Voida. Voida killing off some time in the Eels territory as the rush get a line change out. Colin Patterson in front of the Eels bench. They sit off to the right side of the broadcast position. Rush to the left. Rush getting reinforcements into the end zone. Forsythe for Martin swept to the low slot, and the trigger cannot be pulled by who appeared to be Ethan DeMumbrum. DeMumbrum backwards for Olsen. Flagged down at the middle red by the forward Zach Dill. Dill wrist a shot on, and that's gobbled up by Alex Garone. Zach Dill, no affiliation to Gage Dill of the Florida Eels. Now time for your scratches today for the Eels. Clement Espinosa, TJ Zebley, Cameron Henderson, and Luke Jankowskis out of the action. Espinosa, Henderson, and Jankowskis healthy scratches. TJ Zebley out with an injury. For the Charlotte Rush, sitting out, London Strickler, Devlin O'Kane, Blake Campbell, Russ Tedesco, Aiden Lindley, and Jacob Prizzle. Puck pinballing all around in between the circles. Wrist shot pushed high and dry by Charlie Merkley. Merkley snaps it up to the far point, directed out by Ryan Garau. He ushers a shot on, and Battisti puts the mitt over the disc. We played 3.5 minutes of regulation so far, and we are scoreless between the Eels and the Rush. Face-off coming left side for Battisti, who holds the nickname of Bubba by his teammates. Shuffled to the right point for Tristan Roos. Roos giving go to Podrazov. Wrist it wide. Wrapped out in front. And no shot coming for Casey Gerstein. Gerstein had one goal last night for the Florida Eels. The opening marker in that 4-1 win against the Carolina Junior Canes in the national semifinal. Puck maneuvered out to the neutral zone by Olsen. Olsen looking long distance to Vidrick, but a poke check put in by Tristan Roos. Eels back from square one with Demid Podrazov. Gets to the right point, halted there by Zach Dill. Dill back to the right wing half wall. That's Casey Gerstein. Gerstein nudges out the center. Olsen right there for Charlotte. Eels force it into the end zone. Both teams exchanging possessions back and forth to begin the game. Puck poured in by the Rush, and it's another icing called. This is the back half of a doubleheader today at Shield Ponds. First game today was the Elite Division Championship, where the Charlotte Rush edged past the Charleston Colonials 6-5. So the Rush can double dip today with a championship for both their elite and premier squads. What a way that would be to finish off the 2020-21 season. Four-man jam high up at the left point. Linesman urging the players to keep the puck in motion. Pick loose by Tristan Roos, and he gets stuck in the crowd again. Finally, out to center. It's Penamassov. Penamassov dancing to the left corner, cut off by Davis. Davis going wide side to Dill, who catches out of the sky. Dill hanging on at the hash marks, picked off by Penamassov. That's a glove save for David Battisti as he gets the whistle. 15-12 to go in period number one, zip to zip. Eels and Rush playing for the national championship. Time to introduce you to the head coaches for the Eels. You have Frankie Scarpacci, And he said last night on the Dan K postgame show that his squad has a big time respect for the rush. They admire the forecheck. They acknowledge that Charlotte is a dynasty who makes a deep run for the title year after year after year. They've been waiting for this one. They've been preparing ever since that win last night against Carolina. Puck motion to the left corner and shot back out to center by Scott. Scott beat out to the bunch by Stewart, who splits the team benches. Laced away by Scott. Now Haddon Harris lofting it into his own ice. Colin Patterson forwarding in front of the penalty box wall to Josh Belgrave. Belgrave caroming it to Patterson. Patterson deflects across the opposing blue line off of the backhand, and it's retrieved by Sandbrook. Sandbrook tape to tape with Scott. Scott kicking up the heels at the middle red, and he elects to dump it in. Left hand goes up for Caron, and it's yet another icing. Rush not able to gain the red. For the Rush, at the helm of the team is Trevor Jewell. He played NCAA Division III college hockey at Johnson & Wales University before competing in the Southern Professional Hockey League as well as the Federal Prospects Hockey League. Players congregate along the near side in the Eels end zone. Players moving prematurely in the draw between Andrew and Dill. So we'll do it again. Of course, we mean Gage Dill of this Florida Eels team, not to be confused again with Zach Dill of the Rush. Whittle chops it out to the neutral zone. Wiggled down the left side, shot hammered over the helmet of Caron. Rescued by Sandbrook at the right point. He's bonded up by Casey Gerstein. Gerstein backhands to the front of the net for one of his teammates. Almost a costly turnover. Whittle regrouping at the center logo. Long distance slapper coming in on Caron as he keeps it into the equipment. Eels electing to bring out Belgrade, Patterson, Stewart, McNeish, and Haddon Harris on the full sail line change. Eels victorious in the faceoff circle. It's Patterson steering out at neutral, flips it down for Battisti. Battisti dumps it up to the far side half wall, butted away by Torin Haddon Harris. Haddon Harris with a game winner last night, tries for the wrister, save, rebound coming, and Battisti comes up big, keeping the puck in between the wickets. 13:42 showing on the first period clock. Eels and Rush looking to draw first blood. Battisti has the faceoff coming to left side. Belgrade moving prematurely. We'll have to redo the faceoff as he goes head-to-head with Merkley, who is the team captain for the Charlotte Rush squad. He has committed to play next season in the North American Hockey League with the Northeast Generals. The NAHL, ranked as Tier 2 junior hockey in the United States, USPHL coming in as Tier 3. Tattered to the right circle by Vidrick. Vidrick, backhand shot, rings a scuff off of the back wall. Shugged out to the midpoint, kept in by the Rush. Glove save by Caron. This game brought to you by the United States Premier Hockey League. The USPHL has more than 1,200 alumni currently playing college hockey, as well as 250 professional players, 3 Stanley Cup winners, and 3 Hobie Baker Award recipients. The USPHL, best coaching, best competition, best league. Find out more about the USPHL and playing opportunities at www.usphl.com. Rush starting to evade the offensive zone. Davis, right side of the blue line, now to the near side half boards. It's Jackson Olsen, dueling for possession, fished away out to the neutral ice, and cannot be picked out of the sky by Parrott in the right circle. Parrott blows an edge into the corner, fixed back out to the middle of the rink. Pinamasov wedging it loose nearby the Rush bench, now centered for Parrott at his own blue line. Parrott Snaps one straight forward to Merkley. Merkley puts the brakes on top of the four boards. And a wrist shot gets kicked off the skate blade for Alex Carone. Jackson Olson, rink wide feed in his own territory. And Olson's pass, too much mustard behind it. It floats down to Carone. And again, he keeps it smothered. The Florida Eels team, quick turnaround from last night's semifinal win all the way to the 1 o'clock game today with that championship on the line. The boys slept well as that 4-1 win was grueling against their Southeast Division opponents, arguably one of the most complicated divisions to play out of. The Canes were able to rise above it, get down to the so-called Final Four. Charlotte Rush out of that very same division. Love save produced by Battisti. Florida Eels players frequently communicating with one another in between the whistles. Draw one to the near side by Justin Morozek. Pick free by Torshow, and he rings it off of the bar. Torshow elevating to Cade Swigert, and it's Hemmer racing back out to center ice. Puck unattended at the Eels' left corner. That's dusted off by Easton Moore. Moore finds himself in the midst of a two-on-two scramble behind Alex Carone. Spread up left side of the blue line. Swung across near boards. Davis pounds one on, and that goes left-hand side for Carone. Face-off coming to the left wing. 8 minutes have come and gone in period number one, with both teams getting some incredible opportunities. We saw Olivier Torshow dinging the puck off of the post, but nobody able to find the twine up to this point. Along the near dasher, wiggled up to the point. Eels smothered in their own ice. Pinballed away by Demid Podrazov. Podrazov hacks it out through the middle and down low at the rush goal line to Klein. Klein chokes up possession for Casey Gerstein. Gerstein in a four-man jam. Gage Dill in there for some Florida help. Gerstein loosens up for Dill. Dill is swinging to the front net. Wheeled up for McNeish. Line drive on, and that's gloved onto the end wall by David Battisti. Steered out for Scott, trying to go zone to zone, but to no avail. Casey Gerstein right there for Florida. Podrazov. Backhands up, but not out. Gage Dill there, tape to tape with Stewart. Stewart in the Florida Eels attacking zone, head-to-head with Reed. Miles Reed getting the better of him as Stewart heads off on the line change. Reed hooking with his teammate Martin. Martin splits the team benches. Darts his way into the opposing right circle. Fish back out by the Florida Eels, Torin Hadd and Harris. Harris bumped off by Reed. Those two pinballing the puck back and forth to one another, and it's caromed in front of the penalty box wall. Fork down the right side by Reed behind the cage. Everybody congregating. Eels getting out alive. Wheeled out to center for Colin Patterson. Patterson back along the far dasher for Josh Belgrave. Eels looking to get back into enemy ice. It's Patterson, left side. Man out in front is Belgrave. Pass going to get there in time. Shot coming. Save made by Battisti to keep it a scoreless game. My, oh my, Josh Belgrave waiting right on the doorstep. Right side of the net, but he couldn't pot it home. Battisti looking sharp in between the pipes as he goes head-to-head with Alex Carone on the other end. Two netminders who have absolutely been hyped up by the Dan Kaye Show, the official talk show of the United States Premier Hockey League. Gage McNeish retreats in his own zone, intercepted by Parrott, but not before the rusher called offside. We'll remind you how these teams got to this point. Both of them went 2-0-1 in the round robin. The Eels won 4-1 against the Carolina Junior Canes last night, and Alex Carone was the star of the game, standing on his head with Carolina finishing up 43-20 and shots on net. Casey Gerstein scored a goal. Torin Hadd and Harris representing the game winner at 5:36 of the third period last night. Parrott at his own blue line, angles it down the rest of the rink. Eels have a face-off coming in the end zone. Now past the halfway marker of your opening period of play, 9:15 to go until the first intermission. Two zeros across the scoreboard. wore the rush. They punched their ticket to the national championship yesterday as well, as they dominated the Northern Cyclones with a commanding 10-1 victory. That included a pair of goals in the first period and a jaw-dropping 8 in the second. 8 goals in one period. I'm not sure if I've heard that happening all season. The most goals the Eels have scored in one frame has been 6 against the Jersey Hitmen back in January. Eels with a 2-on-2 in their ice. Wiggled behind the cage by Miles Reed. Held on to at the right wing half wall by Jackson Olsen. Olsen corrals it to the low slot. Nobody home in the Rush white uniform. Rescued at the left side of the blue line, this time around by Trent Sandbrook, the 5'9" defenseman out of Winnipeg, Manitoba, Canada. Puck goes airborne behind Battisti's net. Left corner for Miles Reed. Reed looking to shimmy it up the far dasher, and now Moore halting it against a wall. Sandbrook towards the hash, wheels it out the center, down the slot, and Hunter Howe with a clutch poke check to keep it an even game at 0-0. Charlie Merkley ushering the puck to the far corner. Eels looking to get back out to center, unsuccessful on the clearing attempt from Hunter Howe. Howe one hands it to the blue line for Podrazov. Podrazov giving it up for Olsen at the high slot. Nudged out to the neutral zone, it's Jackson Olsen. Olsen at his own high slot, forwarding for Hemmer. Hemmer with a give and go across the point, offside or the Rush. And it's looking like even Steven style out there on the ice. Both teams up and down, back and forth the rink. This is exactly what you want to see out of the championship game. Head coach Frankie Scarpacci said this time of year, every single matchup is like a chess match. And indeed, that is the case. Trevor Voida stashes the puck across the neutral zone, and that catches a ricochet high off of the banners. It appears that the 3 officiating members are taking the ensuing draw out across center ice. That's exactly what they do. The Eels had in Harris head-to-head with Andrew. Some players moving a little too close to one another along the far wing. Linesman urges them to keep their distance, and we're back to action. Jackson Olsen at the left wing circle in the Rush zone. Scott took it right off the skate. Feeds it backwards to Olsen. Olsen out at the middle of the ice. Treads to the right circle. Dangles past Adam Harris. Swept out in front. And the puck rallied to the low slot. Backhand shot goes away for Hemmer. Adam Harris dodging a bullet on the poke check. Belgrave down the other end. Fighting for a shot in the right circle. He's tangled up in the equipment of Jackson Olsen down low. Big scramble along the back wall. Florida Eels fighting for possession. Colin Patterson has it squirt right off of his stick. And the Charlotte Rush with another clearance. 200 feet for the icing. First period just flying along with 6:49 to go. 0-0 score from Chilled Ponds Ice in Chesapeake, Virginia. The Florida Eels have been in action since Wednesday. Same can be said for the Rush every single day. Now turning into a 5-on-5 for the final game of the season. Regardless of who wins, who losses, this finishes it all up. Puck gets sticked into the spectator area towards the Florida Eels blue line. We'll go back out to center. And one thing I've noticed thus far is this Charlotte Rush back check. Absolutely relentless as the Florida Eels are having a difficult time getting anything rolling out in front of the net. Nikita Pinamasov double teamed at the circles. Right hash for Parrott. Parrott bodied up by Jake Court. He had a golden opportunity to score earlier on in the first off the breakaway, but he was unable to pull the trigger. Jake Court, the Fort Myers native, has played for the Florida Eels organization for most of his life, dating back to when he was a mite. So many Florida Eels players want to win this game for him, He's fought so hard, they say he bleeds Eels green coming right out of Fort Myers, Florida. His brother Jordan played for the team way back in the day as well, as he aged out in 2017. Rush wrapping around the enemy net to the right circle. De Mumbrum lets one fly. Massive collision in front of Caron's cage, and it is taken right off of the pegs. Trent Sandbrook swerved in between the circles and ultimately wasn't able to put on the brakes towards Alex Caron as he ran right into the netminder. The USPHL Premier and Elite National Championships are presented by LTD Hospitality, the USPHL, and Hampton Roads Whalers. Thank the fine folks at LTD Hospitality for housing all of the athletes and league executives throughout the National Championships. Between LTD Hospitality and the Hampton Roads Whalers, who have managed this tournament, it's been incredible. First class as Alex Caron flashes the left-hand glove. The Florida Eels have stayed throughout the week at Aloft Chesapeake, which is a half mile away from the rink. And it's been great for me especially, as this is my 14th broadcast in the span of 5 days. A great privilege to be working with the league in hockey TV for plenty of neutral site games that the Eels were not a part of. So you can take an easy walk over to the rink if you're looking to get your steps in. Overall, great accommodations. Casey Gerstein to the opposing right circle. Dill sandwiched in between two men. Parrott lowering the right shoulder. Gerstein wanders to the high slot. That's dangled on the back wall by Casey. Casey and Olsen rubbing shoulders with one another behind the netminder. Battisti rifled up to McNeish at the blue line. McNeish lets it fly, and that's snagged out of midair by Battisti. The Florida Eels team meals have been provided by Claire Scarpacci and the Florida Eels front office, the wife of Frank Scarpacci, the general manager, the mother of Frankie, the Florida Eels head coach. And that's where the family atmosphere with the Florida Eels began. But the players also agree that they feel so close to one another, like it truly is a family. You hear it so much in the game of hockey, but there's been so many long haulers. Haddon Harris at the doorstep, and he staggers a shot right on the logo of Battisti. I mean, you look at the Florida Eels roster, so many players have been around for years. We're looking at Jake Court, Tristan Roost, who played out to Southwest Florida for the entirety of his junior hockey career. On top of that, you got Gage McNeish, Cade Swigert in their fourth season with the Eels. Right circle surging forward is Belgrave, and a wrist shot leads to a 5-0 save by David Battisti. Flooded down the length of the rink. It's Stewart at his own blue line. Stewart laces it across the middle for Josh Belgrave. He leaves it unattended at the corner. Puck dusted off now by Cam Parrott, the Charlotte Rush defenseman out of Howell, Michigan. Davis corrals out to center, touched up on by Scott. Scott running down to the far half wall. Kick down low for Olsen. Olsen shoots from the sharp angle, blocked away by Caron. Steered out to center by Belgrave. Belgrave give and go to Morozek. Morozek lets it fly. Save made, no rebound provided by Moore. Moore gets it, and he hit the pipe again. That's the second time of the opening frame where the Florida Eels have met the bar. Final 3.5 minutes of your opening period and a scoreless affair between the Eels and the Rush. Winner takes home the national championship of the USPHL Premier League. Moore, massive hit behind the net. That leads to Court getting possession. Court stuck between two different men, and Olsen is able to nudge it back out to center. Fired into the Florida Eels zone, could be an icing. Buck didn't have enough friction, however. Olsen peeling out in front, wrist shot point blank, and that's off the glove hand side for Caron. Nikita Pinamasov intercepted at the red by Whittle. Florida Eels lofted out to the penalty box wall. Good dangle by Olsen, sweeps down low, and the shot goes high and dry by Eli Devereaux. Big hits coming back and forth between these two teams, no stranger to one another, as they played twice throughout the course of the regular season, Rush winning both of those games at two different showcases. Between the circles, Florida Eels carry it out to the neutral zone, courtesy of Jake Court. Maneuvered away by DeMumbrum. DeMumbrum finesses it to Sandbrook, and Sandbrook goes long distance out across the center. Rush taking a couple of moments as they're in the midst of a line change. Now near goal line of Battisti. It's Charlotte's Parrott taking initiative. Gage still nipping at his heels. Picked up by Gerstein. Gerstein pulls the trigger. Goes a mile away. Into the right wing corner. Gerstein paddling low for Gage still. He couldn't get a good read behind the feed. Rattled out to neutral ice. DeMumbrum towards the hash marks. Circuits behind the cage. Now welded to the right point. Parrott fans on the shot. Filtered behind the cage for Swigert. Swigert chips it out across the middle of the ice and down the length. Icing granted against the Eels. 93 ticks of the clock left in your opening 20 minutes of play. Neither goaltender budging so far. Carone and Battisti both having to stand on their head at times. Players gathering along the far dasher. Florida Eels with their backs to their own end. We're back to play up at the 4 point. Vidrick lets loose with a shot. A slow roller on Alex Carone as that got ricocheted into the right corner off of the skate blade. Ran off the back wall. Placed up at the far point, and Garone keeps it into his equipment off of the wrister from DeMumbrum. On the latest Eels line change, they bring out Haddon Harris, Belgrave, McNeish, Patterson, and Stewart. Torin Haddon Harris comes up short in the draw for the Eels. Klein gets the first touch up from the middle of the blue line. Anchored to the corner. Bashed out to center. Josh Belgrave had it squeak in between his skates. Olsen guides out to center. Darted into the right circle for Howe. Howe has the puck squirt right off of his stick. Haddon Harris able to back him up. Torin Haddon Harris at the goal line. Left side swept out in front, and it's held onto by Battisti for robbery. Are you kidding me? Josh Belgrave again right on the doorstep. He's had a couple of golden opportunities through the opening frame. I don't know how Battisti kept it out. It looks like he got his left pad to close that area at the far post. But if there's robbery, that's got to be it. Court chips it to the left corner. Scott works it out the center. Scott directs into the right circle, taken down from behind. No call made on Crossley Stewart, lowering the boom from behind. Court pressures out to the neutral zone, a little too short for his intended man, Benamassov. Scott, right point, offside call against a rush. 22 seconds until we get the buzzer to bring us into the opening intermission. Good showing in the fans between both teams. Plenty of Charlotte fans in the spectator area, as they only had to travel roughly 3 hours to get here to Chesapeake, Virginia. Worked into the left circle. Shot on for Carone, fired out in front of the net. And finally, Podrazov pokes out to center with 8 seconds to shoot. Podrazov elects for the clearance. Near side for Dill. Dill pivots to the right point. That's Hunter Howe with control. Howe lets it fly, and the buzzer sounds. After 20 minutes of regulation, your score is 0-0 between the Florida Eels and the Charlotte Rush. We'll take a break and bring you straight into the middle stanza of play. Live on the Florida Eels Broadcast Network, you're tuned in to the USPHL National Championship. We return for the start of period number two from the Chilled Ponds Ice Sports Complex in Chesapeake, Virginia. 0-0 between the Florida Eels and the Charlotte Rush. Eels moving from left to right across her computer screen. Rush from right to left. Puck meets the ice, and here we go for your middle stanza of play. Gage McNeish wheels this through the neutral zone, stroke down to the left circle for Casey Gerstein. Gerstein works around the back wall, wheeled into the right circle, and back out to the neutral zone to the Charlotte Rush team captain, Charlie Merkley. Merkley races left circle, drops up at the point for Olsen. Olsen winds and fires. That's off the body out in front of Casey Gerstein. Gerstein floats the puck down the length of the ice, and it is recovered along the backboards by David Battisti, the Charlotte Rush netminder. Paddle out to the neutral zone. At the center red, here's Vidrick. Vidrick, drop pass for Merkley, and Merkley bashes one off at the end boards. Nikita Pinamasov at the opposing blue line of his own end. Forked ahead for Roost, and the puck squirts back into the right circle. Battisti taking the rush back to square one. Klein now out of the zone. Pinamasov re-enters from the far point, flips it wide side to Jake Court. Court aims behind the net to Pinamasov, and he's doubled up between two different men. Pressure provided by Jackson Olsen. Unattended puck at the far side, half wall, dusted off by Swigert. 2-on-1 for the Rush. Down the right wall, down the lane, shot coming, and a save by Alex Garone. Whistle blows, even though he didn't have full possession, and the net comes off anyway. A tough situation there for the head referee. Rush bench irate right now. Head referee was waiting down at the goal line far side. But the thing is, Caron was handling on the near side. He didn't have the puck in his equipment. It was loose at the doorstep, so the whistle blew due to that poor vantage point. So a lucky bounce there as Jackson Olsen nearly had a opening marker in this one for the Charlotte Rush. It remains 0-0. Patterson threads it out the center, taken over by Andrew. Andrew in front of the Charlotte bench, sticks it to Martin at the circle. Patterson, now for the Eels, has some room to work with across the middle. Belgrave, out at the enemy blue, whipped away by Andrew at the near circle. Right corner, this is Torin Haddon-Harris. Haddon-Harris, too much friction behind the pass, but he's able to get reunited with possession along the end boards. At the half wall, looped out to the low slot. Pass too far out, stretched to Patterson. Patterson extending for Torin Haddon-Harris at the near post. No shot coming to Battisti. And it's angled out to the neutral zone by the Charlotte Rush. Josh Belgrave rims it around his back while the Stewart. Giving up high slot for Zach Dill. Belgrave with another pickoff. And a bullet dodge there by the Florida Eels. And you cannot let your guard down for a second when it comes to this Charlotte Rush team. One of the fastest squads you will ever see out of the 60-plus team USPHL Premier Division. And that's why it's such an honor to be on this stage, the grandest of them all, in the form of the USPHL Premier Championship. Well over 60 teams, and you make it to the final two? Absolutely amazing. Cade Swigert rims it around the boards, this time in the offensive ice. Behind the cage, Easton Moore. Letting go for Torshow. Torshow stuck in a big crowd and back into the right circle for Miles Reed. Reed has the puck popped into the air, caught out of the sky at the red by Torshow. Torshow lets it loose behind the cage. Rush from one end to the other. Zezima at the high slot, getting some ice time after a bit of inactivity in the first. Caron squeezing tight as he came out of his post to play it. 16:34 to go in your second period of play, 0-0 between the Eels and Rush as a part of the USPHL National Championship. CJ Zezima, 5 feet 9 inches tall. Next season, ready to play with the Corpus Christi Ice Rays of the North American Hockey League. And you have a couple of those null commits on this Charlotte Rush team, and it only makes sense because Coach Trevor Jewell was once a scout for the Corpus Christi Ice Rays, so he has those grand connections for his team. Vitrick high up at the right point, wheels at the right point, poke check by Demid Podrazov. Casey Gerstein lost his stick across the neutral zone, so the pass goes wide and down the rest of the ice for an icing. You also have Alex Davis, who will play next year with the Northeast Generals. Merkley doing the same. Some of the college commits for Charlotte include Sam Martin, ready for SUNY Canton in the fall. Parrott Reeds and Brooks all going to Arcadia University to play their college hockey. Puck meandered down low into the left corner for Gage McNeish. Eels fighting out to their own ice. Wedge behind the cage. Back out in front for Vidrick. And the deflection created by Casey Gerstein. At the middle line, here's Davis. Davis now backhanding to his man Miles Reed in front of the scorer's table. Reed stabs it right circle. Vidrick in the slot. Rotated around the back wall. Outleted high slot for Davis. Davis with a shot at the doorstep. And Garone able to stick out the paddle on the left hand. Right side of the blue line. Angled through by the Mumbrom, and that's tucked into the five-hole area of Alex Garone. Another bullet dodge by the Florida Eels. And the rush starting to gain some momentum after the Florida Eels had a slight upper hand in period number one. All in all, some great scoring opportunities through the opening 20 minutes. And you can tell it's anyone's game up to this point. On the faceoff, rush touch up first with Jackson Olsen. Olsen rifles one on, and a slow roller gets covered by Garone. Again, Garone coming off of an amazing national semifinal game last night. 4-1 Eels beat the Carolina Junior Canes, but he single-handedly saved the game for the Eels, stopping 42 of 43 shots faced with much of the third period being deadlocked 1-1. Right circle for Belgrave. Belgrave shoots on, and Battisti gobbles it up. We played nearly 5 minutes of your second period now. Still 2-0s across the scoreboard. Fans, the Dan Kaye Show is the most watched show in junior hockey. Tune in every Thursday night as Dan Kaye and Lucas Jones provide one-of-a-kind coverage of the NCDC, USPHL, and college hockey. Follow along with the show on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at the underscore Dan Kaye Show. If you want to hire the Dan Kaye Show for your next event, head to www.dankayeshow.com now. Another Eels face-off victory, this time in the offensive ice. Trevor Voida high up at the right point, 10-2 along the left corner by Nikita Pinamasov. A massive hit at the half wall. Some oohs and ahs coming from the Eels bench, no call made. One-on-one for Davis. Davis hits the pipe, back down low, and that's ushered away by Trevor Voida. Davis, left side of the blue line. That's pickpocketed over the crossbar. Shot from the sharp angle doesn't go. Davis, down at the circle. Playing tag back and forth with Hemmer at the goal line. Wide side pass top of the right circle. That skitters around, and Tristan Roos settles it at the goal line. Nikita Pinamasov towards the corner. Back and forth, clashing sticks with Hemmer. Hemmer, back down low. Pinamasov walking out to the neutral zone. Florida Eels fans can take a deep breath. Charlotte rushed that close to drawing first blood in the game. 4 minutes away from the halfway marker of regulation. Patterson can't keep the drive going for the Eels. Malachian fires on from the neutral zone. And Battisti drops the puck off the left-hand side. Haddon Harris almost with a centering feed from the low slot. Pass had too much mustard behind it from Patterson in the corner. Patterson back at the end line. Four boards, left point, no look shot, and that's wide left of Battisti. Rush take it from one end to the other off of dump in, and no call made for the icing. Rush taking the opportunity for some fresh new bodies onto the rink. We see the Mumbrum back out there alongside Vidrick, tattered in front. Oh, Battisti kept it out. Wraparound attempt coming, and that doesn't get across the goal mouth. Haddon Harris with a backhand shot. That rolls away as Danette gets pushed off of the pegs. One thing worth noting is at this point in the hockey game, not a single infraction has been made on either side. It goes to show you that these two teams have discipline, and that doesn't do it justice. It's a total understatement, and it's a big factor as to why they got to this point. The national championship, the gold all on the line. McNeish maneuvers to the midpoint. Reverse back outside for Pinamasov. Pinamasov, side shuffle to Gerstein at the left. Make that Crossley-Stewart. Gerstein out there as well on the same shift. A let's go rush chant coming from the Charlotte Elite team who won their division title just earlier on this morning. Olsen back behind the cage, trying to stroke the puck out in front. Now Klein at the right point, tended down low by Hemmer. Hemmer, Fitrick in front, shot, caught a piece of the iron. And I can tell you something, these two goaltenders with so many lucky bounces. As you get your first penalty of the game, it goes against Charlotte. Eels finally off to the man advantage, and as they come into that first power play line, they are 3-for-17 on the man advantage at Nationals this week. Rush just one goal allowed off of 8 times shorthanded. Prime opportunity for the Eels to get on the board first with 12:38 to go in your second. The guilty party is Anthony Vidrick as he sits down for 2 minutes. Patissi has the faceoff coming to the glove hand. Drop backwards for McNeish. McNeish splitting the blue line, left point for Bodrazov. Bodrazov centering for McNeish, and it's nudged out to the neutral zone by DeMumbrum. Bodrazov spins at his own point. Out across the center line for Tornad and Harris, down low for Roos. Roos can stick it in at the doorstep. Paddled at the far point. Tristan Roos right there for Florida. Haddon Harris fanning on the shot. Filtered high, but not out to the right point. McNeish trying to take a crack at it. Puck sputters out across the middle of the ice. And the Rush trying for the one-on-one. Right point, they're getting some reinforcements in. Merkley streaking down the slot. And McNeish finally gets to turn away for the Eels. McNeish looking to go end-to-end. Right circle drop pass for Gerstein. Five-hole save made on the way from the Charlotte Rush netminder, David Battisti. Far point, exactly 60 seconds to go on the man advantage for the Eels. McNeish, high slot, discards for Roost at the corner. Roost going with a rink-wide feed to Podrazov. Podrazov passes it behind the cage to Gerstein. Gerstein has it flop right over his stick. Puck squirts away at the right circle. Stewart takes it off the skate, midpoint, lets it fly. Save made, scramble at the far post, and Battisti got it off of the blocker. Rebounded for Stewart at the near point. Stewart transforms right circle. He's circuiting around, and a wrist shot caught to Karam at the goal line. Roost down off the back wall. Give and go to Belgrave. Belgrave rallying up to the blue line, looking for a man open, and from there he hooks with Podrazov. Podrazov keeps in. 15 seconds left on the man advantage for Florida. Their first of the game. Stewart on top of the right side. Now four boards for Podrazov. Dangles past a man. That's Hemmer. Save made by Battisti. Rebound! And it goes in, but the puck is waved off. The goal has been waved off, even though the puck went in. This remains a scoreless affair. We played 9.5 minutes of the second, and there's only 1 second remaining on the penalty to the Charlotte Rush's Anthony Vidrick. Casey Gerstein was face down for a couple of moments, not in pain, but more of anguish just knowing that they were that close. I believe what happened is the puck got across the goal mouth, but there was too many people out in the crease of Battisti, and it was goaltender interference. We are calling this game from the near side of the Florida Eels zone. Play transpiring along the other end of the ice. Pinamasov bangs it away. Charlotte Rush back to full strength. Puck caught out midair, low slot. And Pinamasov couldn't drive it home. Podded to the left half wall. Players scrambling it out for a couple of moments. Behind the cage, sharp angle blast. And Howe couldn't hook it home. Driven to the right wing corner. Howe still tending the point. Keeps it across off the backhand. With a little pressure from Vidrick. Eels now in their own zone in a matter of seconds. Morozek one end of the other. Beat to the punch by Vidrick. Both teams duking it out at the neutral zone. Vidrick steering across the opposing point. Left circle for Davis. Davis rips a wrister off the end boards. Morozek rifling back out to the middle. Morozek wrestled up on. He was getting a line change. Three on, three off. Swigert, Belgrave, and Patterson. Those fresh new men coming out. Vidrick down at the left corner. Riding up to the far point. Swigert careens out across that mid-rink. And back around the net of Battisti. Lobbed outside for Voida. Eels back into the end zone with Colin Patterson dumping it loose. Patterson, no shot coming from the midpoint, and it seems like the Rush do an impeccable job of closing the gaps. Zezima with a knuckler, and that goes off of Cade Swigert. But the job's not done yet. Shot sharp angle from the Rush out in front for Klein. And Klein lasers one off of Trevor Voida. Left circle for Adden Harris. Klein gets a touch up. And Patterson gets a ricochet down the length of the ice. No icing called as the puck rattled off of Klein. Klein in the right circle. Rolls it out in front of the Rush benches. Klein tape to tape with Zezima. He's onside. Left side. Blocker behind the net. Out in front. And oh my goodness, Caron kept the puck under the left arm. An outstanding save to keep us knotted up at zero aside. 8.5 minutes until the conclusion of period number two. Alex Caron on fire right now, and it leads to a funny story. Last night on the Dan K Show post-game show, I was able to join in the booth with Dan and Lucas. They asked for my prediction of the game. And I said 4-3 Florida Eels. Frank Scarpacci, the GM, came on moments later, and he said, I'm going to have to respectfully disagree with Nick Rush, as there is no way you're going to get three goals past Alex Caron. He pops the puck into the left-handed glove. Faceoff coming to his right in moments. This game continues to absolutely fly by. It began at 1 p.m. with the puck drop. 2:10 is the time now from the Hampton Roads, Virginia area. This game being played officially out of Chesapeake at the Chilled Ponds Ice Sports Complex, the regular home of the USPHL's Hampton Roads Whalers and the training facility of the ECHL's Norfolk Admirals. Right circle, rushing the attacking ice. Right circle, and a chest save by Caron. Nice snapper coming on the way from the Charlotte Rush forward, Hunter Andrew. But that one straight to Caron's logo. We mentioned it earlier and we'll mention it again. This is everything you want to see out of a national championship game. Both teams back and forth, plenty of great opportunities. But these are two all-star netminders. Patterson rubs it right circle for Belgrave. Belgrave punches one off at the end wall. Steered out to center ice. It's Zezima. Discards right circle. Back across for Iannucci. And he wipes out under his own feet. Torin had and Harris the other direction. He's at the attacking ice. Right circle for Patterson. Patterson shovels one on. And that hop towards the near post. Stepped out across center. Iannucci goes down again. That time from pressure by Edward Malikayan. Dumped up the far wing by Alex Caron. Penalty box wall draw for Torin Haddon-Harris. Leads to a four-man jam. Freed by Cade Swigert. And a hand pass is signaled by the linesman. The Florida Eels' Ryan Garau had the stick lifted right out of his hands by Eli Devereaux. Garau throwing his hands up in protest as if he wanted a fraction against Charlotte. But his wish is not granted. We have a draw in the Charlotte Rush zone. Players congregate along the left dasher. Forked back behind the net of Battisti. Charlotte Rush back from square one. It's to Mumbrum. Airing it out to the near side dot. Klein, able to work his way to the left wing circle, speared away by Goral. Goral bumped off by Vidrick. Now left side to the blue line. That's Zezima down low to Vidrick. Vidrick down to the low slot, careened away into the corner. Now Morozek guiding out the neutral. Moore ushers to the midpoint before he's cut off by Vidrick. Vidrick pinballs it back into the right corner. Eels wanting an icing call and never arrives, however. 6.5 minutes left in your second period of play. Your score, the Florida Eels 0, the Charlotte Rush 0. Rush, high slot, and this wrist shot gets pounded away by Gerstein. Crossley Stewart gets his tape on it. He flags it to the near point. Corden able to catch it out of the air. Howell behind the cage. He's beat out by a step by Zezima. Zezima snaps it to the right point. Around the end wall for Zach Dill. Dill contested by Jake Court. And neither man able to get to it. Instead, it's Hunter Howe. Howe at the end line. Shovels it to the blue line. Dill, no good read behind it. And the Rush having to re-enter as they chip it around the boards of Caron. Caron lets loose out to center. It's Roost all alone. Left circle. Big shot off the forehand. And that is paddled away by Battisti. Puck goes into midair, one end to the other. Cade Swigert skies it out to center this time for Jake Court. Corin Olsen off to the races along the backboards. Court the first one there, but he's unable to maintain possession. Controlled along the near half wall by Zezima. Zezima looking to go zone to zone. Walked up to the far point for Olsen, but Cade Swigert pokes it back out in front of the Eels bench. Centered for Nikita Pinamasov, intercepted instead by Olsen, who's had some outstanding ice time throughout the course of regulation today. Olsen lofts it out across the Eels blue line. Poke check back outside by Podrazov. Dill from the penalty box. Right point, cut off by Olsen. Olsen towards the goal line of Caron, and a backhand shot goes over the crossbar. Zipped out to the neutral zone, it's Gage Dill, and he has this one skied over his head. Malachian lobbing out to neutral. It's Casey Gerstein. Trailer pass to Cade Swigert. Those two split the bench. It's a 2-on-1 for the Rush. Martin at the left wing pokes it through. Save made by Caron. Net dislodged to the near side. The adrenaline absolutely pumping right now. On the ice, in the stands, in the broadcast booth. Everybody is feeling the pressure, whether you're rooting for the Florida Eels or the Charlotte Rush. We mentioned the two teams have played twice before. Rush won both of those games 4-2 on December 20th and then 5-1 on January 31st. December, that was a part of the Florida Showcase. January, the Winter Showcase over in the Southeast. But the thing is as far as I'm concerned, you can throw the regular season records out of the window. Eels have had so many new skaters in the back half of the regular season coming in. Stewart, Belgrave, Torshow, Gerstein, Henderson, Malachian, and you can't count them out. This is a new team when you compare January to right now. Puck batted out of midair by Merkley, and that's a high stick against Charlotte. Faceoff coming to the far side, Daw with a Rush looking into the offensive end. Three and a half minutes until your second period is all said and done. Zip to zip. Eels and Rush duking it out in the national championship. Demumbrum loses the draw. Rush earn it right back. Right circle. It's gained over the crossbar by Demumbrum. Klein back along the near point. Wiggled out to center by Patterson. Could be a 2-on-1 if Florida hurries. Right circle. Down the slots. Harris. Shot on. It's on the doorstep and had, and Harris couldn't bring it in. The Florida Eels have had chance after chance, but it's things like that. You get a half-open net in front of Battisti. All you have to do is swing it through, and they are not able to do that. A couple players who come to mind who were that close to getting on the board first for the Eels. Jake Cord and Josh Belgrave in the first. Now Torin Haddon Harris, as you have loosed, diving to the low slot. Puck loosened up in the right corner. Now threaded away by Demumbrum. Up and on out. McNeish, right point. Down to the near side circle. And the puck gets finessed away by Sam Martin. Martin with an errant pass. Big hit from behind by Crossley Stewart. That's a penalty as the Charlotte Rush head to the first power play of the game. This is where things can get especially dangerous for the Eels. Rush on the power play, 11 for 23 at Nationals. Eels penalty kill line allowed 4 goals off of 11 times shorthanded throughout this week in Chesapeake. First period was free of infractions. 2 so far in the middle stanza. 1 against the Eels, 1 against the Rush, and Charlotte now to demand advantage. Stewart, 2 minute minor, cross-checking the call. Right circle shot, that gets blasted away by Belgrave. Still into Eels territory, down to the left corner. Near side of the blue line, it's Davis. Swings it across, Headley, big slap shot bouncing high, and Belgrave makes the catch. Belgrave slaps it down onto the rink. He's going end-to-end. A little bit of offensive pressure. Swinging around the back of the net. Charges into left circle. Dips back out to neutral where Cade Swigert stands. Swigert lofts it over the crossbar. Davis putting the Rush back to work. A buck 18 to go on the Charlotte Rush power play. Their first of the game. Rush wandering through the middle. Now near point for Zezima. Zezima knocks it at the end line. Caron gets out the paddle, but no dump made. Zezima into the corner again. Up top for Davis. Davis anchors it down low to Zezima. Zezima and Davis playing tag back and forth. Davis, the team captain, spirals it to the right circle. Zezima trying to guide along the back wall, but no can do. Great defense by Morozek. Merkley with a snapper save made. Rebound gets in no man's land at a high slot, and the Eels get their first clearance of the penalty kill. Morozek heading off as he was able to do the honors. 35 ticks at the clock left on the infraction to Crossley Stewart. Ripped all the way down to David Battisti by Malachian. Malachian off on a change. Battisti killing off some time. He got caught behind the net by Belgrave, but he couldn't sweep out in front. Battisti, a very agile netminder, not afraid to move out of the crease on the backboards, maybe even into the corner. You don't have the trapezoid in the USPHL, so these goaltenders can move freely. Martin out across neutral, and we are back to 5-on-5. Both teams 0-for-1 on the man advantage so far. Whipped back in by Martin towards Alex Caron. Vitrick rescues at the right corner. Snap to the far point. And it's Hunter Howe locating it out of his skates. Guided up to the far point. Odd Hopper coming in on Caron. That soars over his head. Redirected at the near half wall. Swigert, right wing out to center. Here's Josh Belgrave. Room along the left side. Stops. Left circle poked out in front. Swigert not able to supply the goal. The defensive-minded defenseman, plenty of experience as a forward, played 2 years at the position with the Florida Eels back when he was younger. Here he is in his fourth season, team captain of the Eels, icing called against Charlotte. Another stalemate in the middle period, same as the opening 20 minutes. Neither team able to crack the scoreboard first. And the right circle, puck banked up for Gage McNeish. He has 12 seconds to shoot for Florida. Stewart on the other end of the zone. Pressured up on behind the cage. Nobody home from there, and that's going to do it for your second. 40 minutes of regulation has come and gone, and your score 0-0 between the Florida Eels and the Charlotte Rush. We'll take a break and come back with your final frame of play. It's the national championship of the USPHL Premier between the Eels and Rush. We've played 40 minutes of action. No goals have been made in this national championship game between the Florida Eels and the Charlotte Rush. Eels coming at you in the final 20 minutes from right to left across your computer screen. Rush from left to right. Puck is dropped, and here we go for your final period of play. It begins with Jackson Olsen of the Charlotte Rush marching across the neutral zone. Pinball is at the high slot, and Demid Podrazov is right there for the Florida Eels. Podrazov lobs it towards the penalty box boards. Charlotte Rush recoiling in their ice. Flying to the left side. Poked out for the Mumbrum. And down the length of the ice. And no icing is given, even though the foot race was won by Gage McNeish. Spread to the far point. Court not able to run out to center. It's to Rush. Hacking one on, and a save made by Alex Caron. First whistle, 38 seconds into your third. And throughout both periods, it's been the same situation. An absolute stalemate. A battle between two heavyweights. But the Eels seem that they have the upper hand. Caron not seeming as challenged compared to Battisti off to our left. Now, I think the big difference in this one is that the Eels have gone those half-open nets, but they haven't been able to drive anything into the twine. Well, it's been a great week of hockey on my side of things. This is the 14th broadcast in the span of 3 days. Make that 5 days. They all start to blend together after a little while. And it seems like when we started on Wednesday, it was so long ago, yet so short at the same time. As there's a duel at the right corner, puck pushes out a play into the mesh netting. That's been a very surprising aspect of the game so far. If I remember right, that's the first time the puck has went into the safety netting above the end glass. Draw coming to the left side of Alex Caron. Off in the near wing. Davis wins it at the blue line. Davis chops it to the goal line. Swept down in front. Nobody home in a wash white uniform. Right half wall for Davis. Davis stymies it in front. And the shot never reaches Alex Caron with all the traffic to the slot. Out to center. Here comes Josh Belgrave. Give him a goal for Torin Hadd, and Harris leaves a scuff off the back wall. Dipped in between the circles and carried back outside by Sam Martin. Martin cruising end to end. Down to the right hash. Rink wide feed to Martin. Big slap shot coming. Gobbled up by Caron. We played a minute 45 of your third period. Scoreless tie between the Eels and Rush. Winner of this game takes home the USPHL Premier National Championship. And at this point in the game, the nerves are high for everybody involved. And the big thing is that players can easily overthink every little move that they make when that's only really going to hurt you. The biggest saying is to settle down and stick to what you know. Play your game, as the cliche goes. But that rigid style of play will only take you so far, as here's a hand pass against a Rush. Players gather along the far dasher. Florida Eels in the attacking ice. Ran backwards by Vitrick. Vitrick in front of the team benches. Splits the blue line. Now into the right circle. He's bodied up by Howe. And no call is made. Rush bench irate at the moment. Gage Dill carries to the enemy right circle. He takes a stick to the face. Still no violations called for either side. Vitrick, high slot, shuffled away by Trevor Voida. Voida pins it out to the neutral zone, shipped away by Davis towards Alex Caron. Caron paddling at the near goal line. Backhands to Hunter Howe in the corner. Howe kicks it to the left circle, played from there by the Mumbrum. And the Mumbrum forced back behind the cage by Torin Haddon-Harris. Haddon-Harris brings the puck off of the bar. And the pass goes high down the length of the ice from a Charlotte Rush member. So no icing, of course. Wide open net for Battisti. Gets back there in time with a little defensive help from DeMumbrum. DeMumbrum, end to end. Now it's Cade Swigert at the penalty box board. Swigert pitches up high slot. Moore couldn't catch it. The disc lies unattended at the corner. Dusted off by Sambrook. Sambrook ladles behind the net. And he couldn't locate his teammate Parrott. 2-on-1 scramble. Tristan Roos at the far half boards. Everybody locking up the brakes. And they're hacksawing back and forth for possession. Torchot has the puck pinned up against his skate. He's keeping it still against the wall. And no stoppage of play comes. 16:23 to go in the third. It's 0-0. Icing called on the rush off of an incomplete pass. Every once in a while on the ice, we will hear some air horns coming. And those are from some of the Florida Eels elite players who have made their way from Fort Myers to Chesapeake, Virginia to support their premier counterparts. Yesterday there was one air horn. It was controlled by Nick Vasquez. Now there are five. Just one of those scared the daylights out of you, and you can hear it in the background of your audio. Wrap around attempt by Davis along the near post. Couldn't bury the puck home. Wiggle to the left circle and a goal. The Charlotte Rush strike first, and it's 1-0 4 minutes into the third. It's Hemmer going five hole and in. You figure that something had to give. The Florida Eels absolutely smothered in their own zone. Up at the far point, Rashad came for what seemed like a mile away, and that finally beat out Alex Garon. It is a mental game in between the pipes, and that first goal given up in the third can take a bit of a toll in between the ears. How will the Eels respond? Here's the goal call.
His fourth goal in action. Score number 20, Shane Hemmer. Boxes with number 23, Zach Dill. Time to go, 4 minutes in the third period.
Hemmer from Dill. Zach Dill with the lone assist on the goal. Hemmer with a big one, the first marker of the day. 4.5 minutes into the third. Colin Patterson laces through center ice. He connects with Josh Belgrave. Belgrave stick lifted by DeMumbrum, delayed offside against the Eels. So it's Charlotte Puck. Lathered on into Alex Garon as he sticks it to Cade Swigert. Swigert on the end boards. Swigert making a run for it out across the middle. Tracked down by Casey Gerstein. Gerstein whacks it down to right dasher. Now left corner for Olsen. Olsen near his circle. Got away to Gage Dill. Dill beat to the punch by Klein. No clearance by Klein. Podges up down low. Dangles. Slot save made by Battisti. Mad scramble for Gerstein. And he couldn't find the empty net. Again, half of it wide open. It seems like we've been saying it throughout the course of the day. Eels is not having very good puck luck in what's been an absolute stalemate between these two. Olsen swipes it out at the middle logo. Gage still heading off on a change. Casey Gerstein meanders near a circle. Olsen punts him off. Now Klein taking a 360 around his goaltender. Battisti not having to get out of the crease at all. Klein from one end to the other. Left circle buried up against a far corner by Gage McNeish. McNeish flips it wide side to Casey Gerstein. Rink wide pass out to center ice. It's Easton Moore. Davis strings it aside to Scott. Scott from his own blue line in front of the penalty box. Side shuffle coming. And a wrist shot over Caron's head. Buck battled around the end glass. Justin Morozek tending to the low slot. Big puck battle at the circle. It transpires into the corner. Back to the far point. Slap shot lands a mile away from Hunter Andrew. Eels out the center. Buck takes an odd hopper behind Battisti's net. It's a 1-0 Charlotte lead. First goal of the game coming moments ago from Shane Hemmer. It came exactly 4 minutes into the third. Now ready to get past 7 minutes. 2-on-2 for the Charlotte Rush. They're in the end zone. DeMumbrum uncontested. Backhand shot save made by Caron as he got out the left leg. Alex Caron continues to be outstanding. And a blow of the whistle arrives. Faceoff coming along the far side. Dodd across center. And this Florida Eels team has historically had some difficulty scoring on the Charlotte Rush. We mentioned when they played twice in a regular season, Charlotte won both games 4-2 and 5-1. So three combined goals across two games for the Florida Eels. Colin Patterson smokes it to the right circle. 1-on-2 for the Eels. Takes a 360 at the half wall. Down low for Patterson. Fixes low slot for Belgrave. Unable to pull the trigger. DeMumbrum nearby the Charlotte benches. Transforms high slot. Side shuffle right side. No shot coming on the way from Sam Martin. And the Florida Eels wash it down to Battisti. Puck not enough friction for the icing call. Sauced up to Howe at the center red. Gage Dill dipping back into his own ice for Florida. Barely kept out of the skates of Belgrade. He's off on the change with Casey Gerstein taking his spot. Tie up back at the blue line for Charlotte. Howe gang into a bit. More hits coming in the Florida Eels zone. Puck unattended at the center logo. Zazima, the first one to it. Puck flies out of the hands of Casey Gerstein. Gerstein towards the goal line. Gage Dill circuits back up to the far point. Gerstein looking for a clearance. Instead paddled away by Alex Caron, the man in net today for the Eels. Podrazov works it across to Howe. Howe finessed away. Wrist shot coming at the far post. And that gets meandered out at neutral ice. 1-on-1 for Tristan Roos. Right side. Punches one straight through the breadbasket of Battisti. We have an 11.5 minutes to go in the third. Your score, the Charlotte Rush 1 and the Florida Eels 0. Off the faceoff, Davis resting behind the net. Pins it to Merkley. Merkley, one side of the rink to the other. Wrist shot, too much muscle behind it. Worked out to the penalty box for a man jam, won by Merkley. Merkley, high slot, almost deep past Swiger, but he uses the tape to his advantage. Spread out, low slot for Merkley, backhand shot on, and that's covered by Alex Caron. Shane Hemmer with the lone marker of this one for the Rush. Glove side faceoff for Alex Caron. Patterson rubs the puck out of his own zone. Gage McNeish shucks out the neutral. Here it's Torin Haddon-Harris. Haddon-Harris left circle over the glove hand of Battisti. Puck pops up high, barely stays in play nearby the spectator area. Haddon-Harris right circle down low to Belgrave. Belgrave at the far corner, transforms behind the net. Looking to wrap around, no time or room to work with. Patterson spaces out, right point for McNeish. Puck flops right over his stick. Quick turn away by Hemmer, the lone goal scorer of the game so far, making it 1-0 Charlotte, 4 minutes into the third. Belgrade. Right circle sweeps it out in front. Save made as we are now halfway marker of your third. Drew Iannucci wrestled down from behind by Morozek. Carter, right point, charges low slot. Five-hole squeeze by Alex Garon. Puck squeaks to the middle line. Cade Swigert trying to wind up. Klein hops in his way, stepped out in front. And Battisti remains an absolute beast in net today. A thorn in the side for the Florida Eels as they look to get on the board. Easton Moore at the Florida Eels bench. Cross-eyes feed coming for Howe. Howe at the red line. Beat out by Drew Iannucci. Iannucci going across. This time he hooks with Sam Martin. Martin flings it down the far glass. Poked up the opposing side by Alex Caron. Rifled out to center by Easton Moore. Brought back across the Eels blue by Shane Hemmer. Eels team captain Cade Swigert handling. Rams it off of the far boards. Now poked away by Hemmer in between the team benches. Hemmer taking matters into his own hands. He's coast to coast at the right point. Slaps it behind Caron's net. Duel along the back wall. It's Crossley Stewart. Stewart motioning out at the mid rink. Dill bodies up Klein. Klein picked off by Torin Haddon-Harris. Puts the brakes on right side. Stewart streaking down the slot, but the pass never got to him. Roost. Chopped away. Rush out to center. 360 taken by Malachian. Stretch pass for Crossley Stewart. Stewart angling near post. Shot right into the logo for Battisti. Eels getting off those opportunities, but some easy saves for Battisti. One of those guys who you really have to get crafty with. You have to strike point-blank range, but the Charlotte Rush back-checking unit just closing up every single avenue for the Florida Eels offense. Swigert lifts it down to the near point. Lobbed out to the middle by Numbrum. Hemmer gets it up to the blue line. Now to the backside of things for Numbrum. Right point. Klein lets it fly. Played perfectly by Alex Caron for the whistle. 1-0 Rush lead. 7:37 for the Eels to find equalizer in the national championship game. Along the near Dasher, face off centered at the blue line, and Vidrick shut down by Caron. One person we were really glad to see today in attendance is Cam Carnes, a former member of the Florida Eels from 2017 to 2019. He took the 10-hour trip south on the road from Boston, Massachusetts to support his former junior team. From the left circle, puck spark back out to the center. Hunter Howe playing it in between the rings. Whittle gets it off the body. He sends to Scott. Scott motioning right circle, one hand, and the puck scattered across the goal mouth. Here's an opportunity for the Eels. Colin Patterson leading the charge in a one-on-two. Lifts it over the crossbar, and it lands at the feet of Cade Swigert. Scott at his own slot. Far side dot, slow hopper in on Caron, he gets the whistle. Cam Carnes again, he's a player who has an obsession with the weight room. And of course we do mean that in a great way, but something that he posts a lot on his social media. Day in and day out, he's one of those athletes who wakes up 6 a.m., heads straight to the gym, and we've noticed an improvement in his size overall, and his frame especially. Gerstein taken to the ice, that's a penalty against Charlotte. Eels do the power play, but let's see here. Gerstein is mad. He's going to the box. It's actually a coincidental. Gerstein and Olsen each heading in. So we'll have 4-on-4 for the ensuing 2 minutes. Gerstein absolutely fuming as the verdict, roughing coincidentals. Casey Gerstein was absolutely fuming as he was let down right on the ice, absolutely dumped, and he threw his hands up in the air asking, why did I get caught?
40 Eels penalty, number 29, Casey Gerstein, 2-9 for interference. Charles Crawley, number 10, Jackson Olson, 2-9 for roughing. Both penalties called at 13:23.
You hear on the public address system that they are not roughing coincidentals, but rather an interference call for the Eels. And roughing against the rush. Left side for Podrazov. He sends this into the mesh netting. We approach the final 6 minutes of the hockey game. Charlotte Rush up 1-0 here in the national championship matchup. Florida Eels still with plenty of time to find that opening marker of the game. We'll go to the nearer boards. Court plops it backwards for Howe. Howe winds and fires, and that's a block out to the neutral zone. That time, a little bit of sacrifice was displayed by Dexter Whittle. And at this point, the Florida Eels need to learn you can't take those slap shots all the way up at the blue line because it results in blockages almost every time. Pinamasov, lasers went on. Rebounded to sharp angle by Court. That doesn't work out either. 1:03 to go until we get 4-on-4 back to 5-on-5. Sesema in between the benches, pushes one straight onto Caron. He's taken to the ice, and that leads to another play being blown dead. Law of action from C.J. Sesema in this one for the Rush. It seems like the further we go along with the game, the more he's out on the rink. He put up a 4-point game yesterday against the Cyclones, registering 2 goals and a pair of assists. The Connecticut native split this season between the Rush and Connecticut Junior Rangers. Bit of a wrestling match at the Rush bench. Lifted behind Alex Caron. Tattered to the neutral zone by Belgrave, and the Rush are back from square one. Davis, tape-to-tape pass to Parrott. Parrott linked back in his own right circle. Hacks it to Merkley. Puck down at the right corner. Wrap-around attempt, not nearly enough room there as Merkley would like. Give and go to the far circle. Redirected at the slot. Eels out to neutral ice. Belgrave goes down. That's a penalty against a Rush. We had 9 seconds left of 4-on-4. That'll take us 4-on-3, Eels for the time being. And then soon enough, it turns to 5-on-4 as Devereaux takes the seat. So again, 9 seconds left. We'll go from 4-on-3 to 5-on-4. Eels heading to the man advantage for the second time today. Grand opportunity to locate the equalizer. Down 1-0, 4:46 now to go in the game. Right now, that clock is absolutely flying. It could not go faster if you're on the Charlotte Rush team. But if you're for the Eels, you're just pleading for time to slow down. Davis behind the net. Klein tosses it to the far point, and McNeish couldn't keep the puck in the end zone. We're back to 5-on-4. Casey Gerstein, the fifth man out for the Eels. Ran back in by Roos. Roos drops back for Han Harris. Harris, trailer pass to the blue line. That goes awry. Olsen sends it 200 feet. 1:35 to go on the Florida man advantage. And for the Florida Eels, they absolutely need to capitalize up a man here. Podrazov peels back at an near point. Puck misplayed by Gage McNeish. Goes straight into the clutches of David. David pours it one end to the other. McNeish forced to retrieve on the back wall. 1:12 now to go on the penalty to the Charlotte Rush's Eli Devereaux. Dill, coast to coast, right side, swiped it across for Pinamassov. High slot for Gerstein. Gerstein can't pick it out of his skates. And Brooks knocks it down to the Florida Eels blue line. At this point, you cannot help but keep your eyes on the clock. It's Belgrave with a one-on-two. Towards the far post, puts the brakes on, and he gets doubled up between two different men. Lofted one end to the other. Alex Caron paddling up in his right circle. Knifed out to the neutral zone for Gage Dill. Dill stymies past a pair of defenders. Delayed offside against the Eels. Now Charlotte puck with 28 seconds to go on the rush penalty kill. Lob back to the Eels ice. Crossley Stewart. One end to the other. Pinamassov finessed away by Vitrick. Vitrick with yet another clearance. Has to be frustrating to see this power play if you're on the Florida Eels team. They've been putting on the pressure, but the Rush defensive core is just next level, and that's a big reason as to why they're such a dynasty year after year in the USPHL. So we're back to full strength, 2.5 minutes to play in period number three. Pinamassov at the left corner. Still can't panic if you're with the Florida Eels, but nonetheless, we'll keep an eye on the bench and see if Frankie Scarpaggi uses his timeout within the coming moments. If that happens, you can only imagine Caron will get pulled from the net. But there will still be a couple of moments. 2:25, a little too soon for that. Score remains Charlotte Rush 1, Florida Eels 0, with a faceoff coming at the far side. Dot Rush with their back to their own zone. Puck squirts back to the right circle for Klein. Ladles on behind the cage to Hemmings. Hemmings, lone goal scored the game so far for Charlotte. Charlotte, left side, pulled on, shot, guided away by Caron. Elbowed into the corner now by Gage McNeish. Popped up on the backboards, Olsen right point. Exactly 2 minutes to go into the game. Eels looking for the equalizer here in the championship matchup. Caron sprawling out. Mad scramble. Puck not secured. Vidrick with a shot. And that got skate bladed away out to center. Neutral zone for Cade Swiger. Picked off by Olsen. Olsen shimmies. High slot. Dances to the right circle. Now centered for Davis. Shot lands a mile away. Now back behind the cage. Glove the puck for Alex Caron. 90 seconds to go in the game. Timeout cannot be called yet by the head coach Frankie Scarpaggi for the Eels, but the draw coming back in their own end. You want to wait and use that timeout for when you're in the attacking end. Caron, face-off coming down the right wing as the goaltender gets set. Davis behind the net, chopped out in front, ricocheted away towards Davis. That puck is skittering all around in the Florida Eels zone. Right wing corner for Hemmings. Hemmings leaves it behind the net, and this time it's out to center for Nikita Pinamassov. Floors a shot on. Easy save made. And again, you need to get up front for Battisti if you're hoping to put anything in. Desperation play for the Florida Eels. Pinamassov, right circle. 4 point for McNeish. Sweeps across court. Court lets it fly. Block it away by Battisti. Rattled in front. Save made by Battisti. Behind the cage. 2-on-1. Poked out in front. Cover up made. And that is where this timeout is going to come for the Eels. I can tell you right now, 43 ticks of the clock left in the game. Eels down by one. Finally, Frankie Scarpaggi gives the signal to the head referee. We'll take a 1 minute break and come back with the final minute of the game. Eels down by one here in the national championship. 43 seconds ago in the national championship game. Eels timeout expires. They're down 1-0 to the Rush. 43 seconds ago in the game. Down at the goal line. Pinamassov whips up to the forward point. Rink wide to Stewart. Stewart shoots low slot. This is batted around. Clearance made by Berkeley into the empty net. That'll do it for this one. The Charlotte Rusher going to clinch the national championship as they immediately score on the pooled net. 30 seconds to go in the game. You hear the ovation from the Charlotte Rush players, their fans in attendance, and the magical playoff run for the Florida Eels is going to come to a close on the final stage. Timeout by the Charlotte Rush. And at this point, 30 seconds to go in the game. Bit of a surprising decision to use your timeout. But if you're going to have one left, you might as well. Charlie Merkley gets the goal, the second one of the game for the Rush. First one came from Shane Hemmer, which was right here in the third. These two teams had a stalemate through the opening 40 minutes of regulation. And the Rush come together. They clutch up out of the locker room. Score 4 minutes in. And the Charlotte Rush celebration is on. The Eels have never won a junior hockey championship in their 15 years of fielding a team at this level of hockey. They played in one title game before in 2016, a 3-2 defeat at the hands of the Hampton Roads Whalers, and they fall short today to another Southeast team in the title game, this time against the Charlotte Rush. 15 seconds to go. Torrin had and Harris at the near point. One last stand for the Eels. Empty net again, and this goes wide right. 5 seconds left. Icing called. One last faceoff is going to do it. Eels go to the attacking zone, but they're down by two. And we've mentioned the Charlotte Rush, just an incredible defense.
Once again, a reminder to fans, you cannot enter the ice surface.
Right circle, puck meets the ice. It's covered up in the corner. Ladies and gentlemen, that is your hockey game. The Florida Eels run comes to a close in a disappointing manner as the Charlotte Rush are your 2021 USPHL Premier Champions. Absolute heartbreak for the boys from Florida. Not many people expected them to get this far. And when it's a league of 60 plus players, getting to the top two, nothing to scoff at. But the Eels want the gold. Everybody plays to not only win the game, but win the whole championship. And this is how it ends. The Charlotte Rush win by a final score of 2-0 with a pair of tallies right here in the second. First one coming from Shane Hemmer 4 minutes into the third. And then it's all finished up by Merkley with an empty netter in the final minute. Well, fans, Nick Rush giving you the play-by-play from the Chilled Ponds Ice Sports Complex in Chesapeake, Virginia. Thank you so much for tuning in throughout the course of the regular season. It's been an unprecedented campaign, a lot of trials and tribulations due to COVID-19, but it's been a major success for the USPHL in the sense that they were able to get things going from the start of training camp in August all the way to the national championship game here in March. And although these players from the Florida Eels were blessed to get in the 2020-21 campaign, that doesn't stop the heartache knowing that they came so close to capturing their first ever league championship in team history. The Florida Eels waiting at their own blue line. Celebration continues for the Charlotte Rush. an absolute dynasty that makes a complete run, it seems like, every single year. Head coach Trevor Jewell has something to be proud of. Same can be said for Ryan Carruthers, the general manager of not only the Charlotte Rush, but the Charleston Colonials as well. Rush and Colonials had the championship game in the Elite Division. And the Rush double dip. They get the title in both the Elite and Premier Leagues. We've never seen anything like it. Handshake line taking place out across center ice. One of the greatest traditions in the sport of hockey. Florida Eels finished the season first place in the Florida Division. It came down to the final game, but they made it happen, squeaking past the Tampa Bay Juniors. They went 2-0-1 in the round robin, defeated the Carolina Junior Canes last night 4-1. But the luck comes to a close in the final game. 2-0 Charlotte Rush win, as they will be the squad to hoist the title at Chilled Ponds. Again, a huge thank you to all who have tuned in throughout the course of the season. All of the staff members, the parents, the players. We could not have had this season without you. And we truly are grateful for all of your efforts to support these players on the rink. That'll do it from us here in the broadcast booth. Here in the championship game, your final score, the Charlotte Rush 2 and the Florida Eels 0. Here in premier action, Nick Rush giving you the play-by-play, saying thank you for tuning in and so long from Chesapeake, Virginia. Rush your champions in the premier, but have a great start to your week. Have a great start to your offseason. A safe spring and summer. So long, everybody.